Today on Upfront, a new era of enforcement for protests at the state capitol. Next, Capitol Police Chief David Erwin answers protesters who say he's infringing on their freedom of speech.
People are making this about the First Amendment, and it's not about the First Amendment. It's about the permitting process, and it's that simple.
Plus, new action on a mining bill. What's different this time around? It's all this week on Upfront.
Honest, candid, insightful. This is Upfront with Mike Gaucher.
It's called the Solidarity Sing-Along, and it's a daily occurrence in the Capitol Rotunda. Now, some protesters at the Capitol are feeling the heat. Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. The new Capitol Police Chief is taking a tougher stance with some of the protesters who've been fixtures at the Capitol since the collective bargaining battle. That's not sitting well with the protesters, who accused Chief David Erwin of violating their First Amendment rights. I sat down with the chief at the Capitol last week.
It's been an interesting few months. Describe for me what it's been like for you.
Well, you know, it has been an interesting few months. It's exciting times. You know, I spent 16 years in the State Patrol prior to coming here, 8 years on the governor's detail. So kind of knew what I was getting myself into here at the Capitol. It's a beautiful place, a majestic place. You know, as we were talking before, it's a great building, and the city's beautiful. So, you know, it is an exciting time here, you know, trying to work through the process, the permitting process. You know, and that's kind of where I'm at right now. I'm spending a lot of time on the permitting process here at the Capitol.
I want to talk a little bit about that because I know you've said you're essentially, you believe you're just enforcing rules that really have gone unenforced for some time. There are people who say, no, you've gone too far, you're too aggressive, you're infringing on free speech rights. Do you think there's a clear understanding of what is and isn't permitted in the Capitol right now?
Well, you know, we're trying to ensure that there is a clear understanding. You know, for 33 years, there has been a permitting process here at the Capitol, and we just want to share this beautiful, beautiful space. And that's what's most important, is being able to share this building. But, you know, it's people are making this about the First Amendment, and it's not about the First Amendment. It's about the permitting process, and it's that simple. You know, I will work with anyone through this permitting process, including hand-walking these through to get these permitting. The permitting process costs zero, nothing, not one dime to have. And so, you know, I struggle with the fact that we have this process, and I also struggle with the fact that even some of the legislators that have sent letters to me have used this permitting process. And so I don't understand. I think there's some mixed signals going on out there, but I just want to make it very clear. The permitting process is free. We will do what we can to work with you. And you know, there are always safety considerations. You know, I think back, you know, on the extreme side, you know, we had an archery team that wanted to come here. So obviously we can't use an archery team here. But, you know, there are union groups that share this building, that get a permitting process. There are military groups. There are neo-Nazi rallies that come here. And we support free speech 100%.
I want to have you mentioned union groups. And you know, in the last week or so, you had the Dane County Sheriff's Union and the Madison Police Officers Union say, you know, we're concerned about First Amendment rights perhaps being limited at the Capitol, and we're concerned about maybe the safety of some of the officers who are asked to carry out a little stricter policies than in the past. What's your response to that?
Well, you know, we are police officers. We take an oath to protect and serve, and that's all citizens. And so, you know, as far as what we're doing here and as far as those union groups, they are union groups. I mean, they're associations. And since then, I have had officers from those departments come up to me and say, hey, we stand by what you're doing. You know, we know you're following the law, and that's what we're doing. It's prohibited acts. We, you know, I don't make the laws. I just simply am tasked with enforcing them.
When you say prohibited acts, give us examples.
Like, you know, a prohibited act would be assembling here without a permit with a group, being disorderly. That's a prohibited act. I mean, if you want to break down what the permitting process requires, it says four or more people. And, you know, if you come here, and a lot of people go, well, why four? Well, I can tell you with my department, it helps me manage. Like, you know, if you say four people, and let's just use the number. It takes three officers. If those four people decide to be disruptive, to remove, well, that's 12 people. I mean, 12 officers that are required. And that would just be committed to that permitting event. So if you think about that number, you think just for resource-driven, it's a fair number. But even with that being said, if you're being disruptive, you know, if you're having a wedding or an event here and you expect some privacy, some respects, some way to enjoy this, so you can enjoy this building. You would think that we would keep people out of your wedding. And that's really all it is. It's really about sharing this majestic building.
The people out there might say, okay, how do you define disorderly? How do you define disruptive? Is there some gray area in the definition of those?
Well, disorderly is, you're being disorderly. I mean, if you're trying to conduct an event, whether it be this interview, and you can't, you're unsuccessful. If you're trying to conduct business in this building, which we have, and people call down and say, listen, I can't work. I can't put a product out. I can't hear myself think. We can't hear the phones ringing. That's obviously disorderly, disruptive. And that's kind of what we've been doing. So you got to, and even when we have people that follow the permitting process. We had a choir last week, and they wanted to practice prior to their time, which is understandable, right? So they started singing. We actually sent somebody and said, hey, just bring it down just a little bit. People are trying to work. And they worked with us. They backed it off a little bit. They did that. And that's what sharing a building's about. That's, we're all trying to work. This is a workplace. There are a lot of workers that work here.
I did want to ask you about a comment you made in another media interview, and some lawmakers were, I think, offended by the comment, but you said that there are people in this building, some people, whose actions are like those of terrorists, that they're terrorists in some respects. What did you mean by that?
Well, this is what I said, and there is a difference. I said they were terrorizing, and I had been talking to someone, and they said, I'm tired of being terrorized, and so, it may, a poor choice of words, I would say, considering the timing, but there is a difference between being terrorized and being a terrorist. And I did not call them terrorists. And I said they were being they're terrorizing people in this building. And when I'm thinking about that, I'm thinking about, the one gentleman that stood outside the media office and sang about someone's father who passed away. I mean, that's ripping right to the core, to the heart of what we're not about. And so, I think about those issues, that extreme example, and that's pretty hard to take.
Give me your assessment of where we go from here.
The numbers are around the 50, so they're not probably about where they were before. We have peak days. On the biggest peak day, we have under 200 people, that come here, but that's very rare. Numbers are around 50, 60 people that are in and out of here at the sing-along. People are complying. We are seeing a change in demeanor here. People are trying to comply. Every day, this is what I can tell you, there are pressures within this group that are giving people pressure, because there are people saying, I'll step up and get a permit. All I need is one person to get a permit, and then the activity is pretty much legal. There have been days here where everything that we observed, except for having a permit, is completely legal. They're holding their banners, they're not being disruptive, they're keeping their decibels down, they're not blocking the aisles, if they had a permit, it would be legal. And we've had several days. And if we have law-abiding citizens here, and that's who this group says they are, just get a permit. And then you can, if you want to fight it later, fight it. But just follow the rules now, like we all have to do, all the people that share this building.
Next, the Democrat hoping to succeed Tammy Baldwin in Congress. I'll talk with Mark Pocan about what he will and won't do if he goes to Washington. That's when Upfront continues.
Upfront with Mike Boucher, brought to you by American Transmission Company and the Wisconsin Corn Growers Association.